Here's the plan. We get the warhead and we hold the world ransom for $1 million.
What's up, Cinemaniacs? I'm back with my review for the third film of this mediocre franchise that is known as the Divergent series. This movie is Allegiant. No, I'm not going to totally just bash this film over and over and over again. You know, for things like its poor CG or its blasé story or even how incredibly horrid the love story is. I'm not going to just completely bash it the whole time. Because, as this franchise has gone on, it actually has gotten a little better. The action in this movie was actually pretty decent. It was very entertaining, at times, and if you couple the decent entertainment with them actually seeming to find a balance between the action and the comedy that was thrown throughout there with, like, Miles Teller's character. Because he does a very good job with comedic timing. He knows how to make the audience laugh. And he does. He brings you some serious laugh-out-loud moments in this film. And actually, the thing about Miles Teller's character in this movie, and then seeing Theo James, who plays Four, I just got taken out of the movie for a few minutes because all I would think of is how good they would probably be together if they did like a buddy cop film. Like, Miles is that kind of sharp-tongued, loose cannon, while Theo James plays the straight-by-the-numbers go-getter. I think that they would play really well off each other, and this buddy cop idea would probably be a hell of a lot better than we're getting out of the Divergent series. Okay, if I'm actually going to get into some of the characters that are in this movie, because I've already talked about Four, I've talked about, I don't even know what Miles Teller's name is in this movie, I just know that he's the funny guy, but I'm going to get into Shailene Woodley, because I just don't buy her as this really strong woman who is going to get things done. I don't know what it is about her. I know she's a very talented actress, like you've seen in Fault in Our Stars. She has the ability to really carry a film. I just don't think that this is the role for her. I'm just unsure about what it is about Shailene Woodley. It might just be that her face just looks too nice. Like, she just seems like too nice of a person. And I just don't buy her being this kind of tough badass. I just don't buy it. But with all of that being said, you do get some nice twists in the movie. I mean, you can kind of see them coming from a mile away, but you do get some twists, and the movie does feel like a little larger in scale, and I do think that the cast did flow together a little bit better. But that's not necessarily all that good of a thing, because improving upon crap is not anything to really brag about. It's like polishing a turd. It's still a turd. And even though that the cast and everybody all kind of flowed together, the action and the comedy was kind of balanced a little bit better, you need to make this story flow. And this franchise has always struggled with that. The downtimes, the forced relationship between Four and Triss is just boring, and they don't seem to have any chemistry whatsoever. And that all falls back onto the director. He needs to make that chemistry pop. And if it doesn't, that's his fault. Because I do think you could chop 10 to 15 minutes off of this film and tell the same exact story. Also, the director's fault. And the last thing I will say about this film before I give my rating is also in with the direction. Continuity. When someone gets hurt and is limping around, you can't have them go to the next scene and doing some crazy ass moves that Bruce Lee would be like, "Damn, son." The picture that you have painted from scene to scene with this person's pain is now out the window. You cannot go back to it. You don't go from limping around to crazy ninja kicks. I don't care how much adrenaline you have, it doesn't happen. Okay, so the movie wasn't horrible. I actually found myself a little entertained occasionally throughout the film, which is why I am going to give Allegiant a 5.5 out of 10. Yes, this is the best film out of the mediocre franchise, but it still has a long way to go to be considered good. Have you seen any of the Divergent series? What have you thought so far? Are you looking forward to Allegiant? Did you like my review? Let me know what you thought in the comment sections below. And if you get the chance, go over to the lower right-hand corner and click that subscriber button. It's a little logo. You can find it. CineTalk by the CineBros corner. Subscribe. Once again, subscribe to us at youtube.com/themoviehousemaniacs and get your movie entertainment on. Or if you're on your laptop, you can hit this button. Boop. And you can also subscribe to the channel. Once again, I hope you enjoyed this review, and I hope it gives you a little better idea of what you may or may not want to see this weekend. Peace!
If you watch the show on YouTube, please click that thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. And thank you for watching.